الحمد لله الذي نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. ثم صلاة وسلام على البشير والنذير والسراج المنير السهر الظاهر العلم الظاهر المنصور المؤيد أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد. وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، لا سيما باقية الله في الأرضين من صاحب العصر والزمان، روحي وأرواح العالمين لتراب مقدمهم الفداء. يقول الله المولى سبحانه وتعالى في محكمه تنزيل بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: لقد من الله على المؤمنين إذ بعث فيهم رسولا من أنفسهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة وإن كانوا من قبل لفي ضلال مبين. آمنا بالله، صدق الله العلي العظيم. Respected brothers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise be to Allah سبحانه وتعالى for granting us this opportunity and chance to be present today on this auspicious day of Jumu'ah, to participate in the Jumu'ah in the Jama'ah in the Masjid. Such a great honor for us and a blessing. There are so many brothers and sisters who wish to be with us today to participate in Jumu'ah, but because of different tasks and different assignments in their lives, they don't have the chance, the opportunity. Every little chance and opportunity you get to stay in the Masjid, to participate in good deeds, it is an honor, it is an invitation by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, and every such occasion necessitates shukr, thanks. You need to thank Allah for such opportunity, inshaAllah. Today's discussion is about the tarbiyah of Jama'ah, is about educating ourselves and educating our community. The discussion that we discussed last night after Dua Al-Kumail, inshaAllah, I would like to invite brothers who are around. Every Thursday night we have Dua Al-Kumail and we have discussions of the Quran, inshaAllah, to participate, inshaAllah, in those gatherings, inshaAllah. The discussion we start is about the Jama'ah and the congregation, the Jama'ah, Mujtami'ah, society, or a group of people who are like sharing the same views, sharing the same destiny, sharing the same dangers, sharing the same. Therefore, they create their own laws, they create their own civilizations, because together as a collective people, they share the same risk, they share the same opportunities, they share the same dangers. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when describing the community and mujtama and the importance of amru bil ma'ruf wa nahyu anil munkar, this principle we have in Islam that we have to stop evil from taking place and we have to encourage good. When he explained this concept, he said the Muslim ummah, they are like people, the people in the community, they are like people who are sitting in one ship. We are sitting on one ship, we are crossing Atlantic, we just live in Cape Town to Atlantic, we are going to cross Atlantic to other part of the world. If we are on that sea, we are sharing the same destiny. We are all going to one destination. If we succeed, we are sharing the same happiness of getting there, across the sea. And if something endangers our ship, we are all sharing the same destiny. If it's going to drown, it's not going to drown only on me or you. So it doesn't matter in the ship, we know there are classes. There are those who are flying first class in an aeroplane. From here to Cape Town, they are paying first class. They are sitting where it's one room, a cabinet, you have cold drink, you have a fridge, you have entertainment, and there are those who are poor in the main hall, you know, on a plane. Those ones, whether they are on the main hall or under the cabinet, we're in the first class, we are on the same flight. If the flight has a danger and is going to be crashing, all of us, we are sharing the same responsibility. That is an example of a Jama'ah, a Mujtami'ah, a society. If we are Shia Muslims in this city, in this town, we are sharing the same destiny for our children. We are sharing the same. Therefore, you cannot confine yourself in your own home and say you are going to do your dua al-kumail, your dua al-tawassul, your aman, and then you don't care about what's happening with others. You don't care whether others have made it or not. That's the importance of amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy an. You can be a great personality in a community, in a society where no one is doing good. You are mas'ul. Danger of that society is going to reach you, whether you are being good or bad. We have one hadith that speaks about one village. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to destroy the village. The angels, when they went to that village to actually destroy it, they found one man who was in sajda, making salah. They went back and said, "Ya Allah, how can you destroy this village and someone who is making sajda in it?" Allah said, "Go and start with that person. Because he's doing salah, he doesn't care if the neighbor is making salah or not." He didn't teach his neighbors. He didn't communicate whatever good he's doing to others. Therefore, start with him, because the destiny of the whole community relies on everybody's effort. So when we discuss about a mujtama and a society, that is what we mean by a jama, is a society. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he's in a verse I started with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, لَكَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been merciful unto believers. إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا, when he raised a messenger among themselves, يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُ رَبِّهِمْ. Rasulullah was raised among a community, a society of Arabia, which was ignorant. The time in which Rasulullah was raised, it was a time of Jahiliyyah. The historians refer to that moment as Jahiliyyah, ignorant era. In that ignorant era, everything was in the abyss. Society, community were committing all the worst of the crime. Allah received the messenger among themselves to establish a new society, a new community, a new mujtama. Khayru ummah. Kuntum khayru ummah. Ukhrijat lin nas. And that community that Rasulullah established from the rotten people, he started by educating them, tarbiyah, teaching them, yatlu alayhim ayatu rabbihim. The principal role the Prophet did in Mecca was to teach them, yatlu alayhim ayatu rabbihim, was to teach them this book, ayatu rabbihim, the teachings of this Quran, the verse of the Quran. Wa yuzakihim, was to purify them from the bad deeds, the jealousy, the anger, the fighting, all the dirty things that they were indulging, to remove those from their hearts, to clean them, yuzakihim. Wa yu'allimuhum al-kitaba wal-hikmah, teach them the book, teach them the wisdom. After they were taught, then they became human beings. Islam came to teach people how to become human beings. The role of Islam is to remind insan to come back to the principle of ubuntu, ubuntu. Religion is nothing more than being a human being. Once you are a believer, then you become a better human being. Without this tarbiyah, without this education, you are not a human being. Sociologists agree that a human being is not born a human being. You don't acquire humanity by being birthed. It's not a right of birth. Come on, someone by sociology, they say a child of a human being is not a human being. A child of a human being becomes a human being by education, by being trained, by being taught. Tarbiyah is the one that change that little animal that is born from a mother to become a human being. Sociologists have gone to extend to say there are societies in Asia, in India, where some animals kidnap human beings, children. Kidnapping a child, then they eat some of the children and they raise some of them, like baboons. They can take a human child and go and raise him. That child becomes baboon. He eats grass, he climbs the trees. Everything of that child is human being, but he is baboon. Therefore, sociologists, they say, a human being is not a human being by birth. It's a human being by what? Being trained. he's taught, he's trained to become a human being. Without this level of education and training, we don't have human beings. We have a bunch of animals who are morphologically, physiologically, anatomically, we are humans. But our akhlaq, our training, our belief, our deeds are not human. That's why Quran says, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً. Whoever doesn't have dhikr, turns away from the Quran, the teachings of Allah, he has a worse form of life. And other verses of the Quran, Quran say, أُولَٰئِكَ كَلْ أَنْعَامِ. Those people are not different from animals. بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلْ. They are worse than animals. Why? Because they can live in worse things than human beings. The education, the creation of Islamic society, that's why Allah says the messenger starts by training people first how to become human, how to love your neighbors, how to become a human being. And therefore, once they were trained in the Quran, in the Sunnah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to them as kuntum khayra umma ukhrijat linnas. You are the best of the ummah. That's why we take pride from the companions of Rasulullah. That's why we take pride from the nation that Rasulullah raised, from the state of Medina Rasulullah established through education and training of being a human being. Therefore, today, when we are complaining about our community, when our communities can do nothing together, when our people are lazy to work, when our people are lazy to improve their lives, when our people are lazy to do businesses, when we can't do anything, sometimes we blame our youth today. But it's not their problem. It is a tarbiyah they receive. It is two possibilities. Either our fathers, if the complainer comes from us to know, no, I give you a blame for Rasul, who to say, anything we blame more of Rasul, Mara. How the community that is not going to, we have two possibilities. Either, they were hard workers, they were visionaries, then, but they failed to instill those akhlaq, those trainings in us. Therefore, we became a nation of, or they were not, and then we inherited who we are today to represent our fathers. Who our communities are today represent the generation before. Therefore, if we are a successful generation, if we are a Muslim Ummah, without taking attention to educating ourselves, tarbiyah, yatlu alayhim ayatu rabbihim, wa yuzakihim, everything of ours, if we want to correct our affairs, we must start by starting educating ourselves, training ourselves, educating ourselves. If we don't want to read books, if we don't want to attend workshops, if we don't want to attend majalis, the mosque, we are going to remain as we are. But we need to start from where? From tarbiyah. Our communities are who we are because of yesterday. The role our parents played yesterday is reflecting in us today. And if you want to see our children tomorrow, look at us today. Look at how we are doing today. Look at how are we organized today, and see exactly tomorrow, 100 years to come, our children, how they are going to live. Society, Muslim community, is like a kettle of water. You know a kettle of water? If you put more water and you close the... If you empty the whole container and you put new water, there's no communication between the water that is going out and the one that is coming in. Our children must have connection with us, with our centers, our beliefs, so that whatever we are trying to build, our community, our children can go on. We are sitting with a pandemic today. Our elders are dying day and night. And you must know that the masajid, the centers are always full of elderly. If I look in the masjid there, I don't see a child of 10 years, 12 years, 15 years coming for Jummah. I know when this generation goes, no one will come to this masjid. There's no tarbiyah. We are not raising our children to come to the masjid. We are not raising our children to come to majalis. Therefore, tomorrow, that's why in many communities, when elders go, you will never see those masajid again. So inshallah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us tawfiq and to give us understanding that we need to participate in tarbiyah and educating ourselves if we want to start our community. If we are not, we are a community without goals, without sharing the same destiny, without sharing the same love, same compassion, we are not a jama'ah. We are people who attend the masjid together, but we are not yet a jama'ah. Quran says, تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. There are those people you see, and you think that they are a jama'ah. They are because they are together in the masjid, but they are not jama'ah. قُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. Their hearts are separate. Their hearts are not together. Their hearts don't wish good for one another. Their hearts don't share the same destiny, same pain, same happiness. We are just a bunch of people who can attend together, but we are not yet achieved that status of jama'ah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us that status of mujtama'ah, jama'ah, where Quran says in the Quran that Muhammadun Rasulullah wal-lazina ma'ahu asidda'u ala al-kufar ruhamma'u baynahum. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. And those who are with Muhammad, his followers, asidda'u ala al-kufar, they are very hard when it comes to unbelievers and transgression. Ruhamma'u baynahum, but their quality is that they have love for one another. They have compassion for one another. They will die for one another. They will sacrifice for one another. Our community without these values, we have not yet achieved the jama'ah, and we are not yet with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us that closeness with Muhammad and his values, inshaAllah. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr. Ila alladhina amanu wa amilu s-salihat. Wa tawasaw bil haqq wa tawasaw bis sabr. بارك الله لي ولكم بالقرآن الكريم ونفعني وإياكم بذكر الله. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو السميع العليم. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.